In the previous video, I expounded the thought of what is or what may be a god. I briefly explained how gods have not always been immortal or incorporeal beings, and that the only difference between us and all the gods that we already know is not a specific ability, or rather the measure of each ability. But I am aware of those who say that we can never be considered gods because we are limited, whereas God is unlimited in all his qualities and abilities. But is that really true? If you assert that omnipotence or the ability to be or do everything makes one a god, would you not be indirectly proposing that the lack of any ability is an immediate disqualification of godhood? In this case, our main question will be, if omnipotence is an exclusive quality of a god, can any god retain or maintain godhood? First, I will present two verses from the Hebrew and Christian Bibles, and the orthodox idea behind each one. Here is the book of Numbers, chapter 23, verse 19, where it says, God is not man, that he should lie, or a son of man, that he should change his mind. With the exception of a few Jews who have been influenced by Hellenic philosophies, Orthodox Jews take this verse as proof that God cannot incarnate. Now Christians will be saying, well, who are they to say what God can or cannot do? So this one is for you faithful Christians. The book of Hebrews, chapter 6, verse 18, as it says, so that by two unchangeable things, in which it is impossible for God to lie, we who have fled for refuge might have strong encouragement to hold fast to the hope set before us. Based on this verse, all Christians realize that God cannot lie, so in the end, having a body and the ability to lie are two privileges that mankind enjoys, which are to an omnipotent God such as the one of the Bible, off limits. And that's based on the two greatest religions in the world. Now here's one last idea to challenge this paradox. If God can do everything, then he should have no trouble relinquishing all of his abilities and becoming a mortal for one moment. But after that moment, would he still be able to gain access to his former godly powers, or will he die a mortal?